You're going to recognize our next guest as the cool guy in Heathers or in the movie True Romance, but his latest role...
Hey, that guy.
Whoa, whoa, hey!
But his latest role may be the coolest one he's done yet, other than that move.
A lot of yap yap and not a lot of zap zap.
That's crazy. Nobody would do that.
Josh, tase yourself in the face. It's for work.
I do that.
Now there's a guy who gets things done.
That was camera hog Christian Slater.
Yeah, right? Working his way into every shot. That's what I do.
A brand new series Wednesday nights on Fox after American Idol. You were working last night.
I was on TV last night.
We
shot it certainly a little while ago. I was at a show last night. That's what I went to.
Listen, that is a funny and good series you're in.
Yeah, no, it's fun. It's definitely a great cast. It's a funny premise. I love this character, Oz. He's definitely quirky, eccentric, and has some very bizarre methods on how to run an office.
Right, and he presides over kind of a bunch of oddball geniuses who go out and get the job done.
That's right, yeah. Computer hacker, lock picker, master of disguise, gadget guy. They're all, they're an interesting, eclectic bunch.
Sounds like you're kind of playing yourself.
In a way, yeah. Well, that was one of the things I was really happy about. When I sat down with Adam Goldberg and Doug Robinson and Seth Gordon, the character of Oz hadn't been fully fleshed out yet. So I think they were looking for an actor to kind of contribute some ideas and incorporate some of their own personal eccentricities and oddities into the character. And I was more than willing to oblige.
I bet.
Yeah.
And one of the great things about being a star on a show is you can always suggest, you know, I got a suggestion for somebody who could be on the show. What about my friend Jimmy Johnson, the NASCAR guy?
Yeah. When they were developing that particular episode, they mentioned NASCAR. I said, yeah, look, if we're going to do a
NASCAR... You drive fast.
If we're going to do a NASCAR episode, then Jimmy Johnson has to be our guy. And look, there you can see
Gentlemen.
Me. I'm the...
You're Grand Marshal, right?
I was the Grand Marshal, yeah.
Start your engines?
Yeah, I said, gentlemen, start your engines. And what's great is they hand you the mic a couple minutes before you say it, and they keep the mic live. So I'm standing there in this big crowd with, you know, the whole crowd there, and I started singing Sinatra tunes and having a great time.
They let you get in the car?
I did. I got in the pace car.
Yes.
I'd done the pace car thing before. I also did the Toyota Grand Prix a couple of years ago. That was fun.
And let me ask you this. Is there any similarity between being an actor and liking to be a race car driver? Is there the same thrill element there?
Jimmy and I did talk about it a little bit because, you know, when he first got there, he was, you know, a little nervous, definitely sort of unfamiliar territory for him to be in. But we realized that it's a very, in a way, a similar business. I mean, he has to do the same thing over and over and over again all day. And pretty much that's exactly what we do. We just go around and around.
Yeah, but have you ever had a blowout on the set?
I've seen it happen, and it's not pretty.
American Idol, we saw you in the audience.
Yeah, yeah.
And you were sitting next to your daughter.
That's right. Oh, look at that.
There's the picture right there. She must have been thrilled to be able to be there.
Yeah, I think certainly one of the things I'm probably most grateful for as far as getting to be an actor and doing what it is that, you know, we get to do is we get a lot of opportunities. And certainly that was one of her dreams to be able to go to that show and sit there and have that experience. So that was a real treat.